the government, baka naman ang ating gobyerno ay pwede rin magpausok, di ba? Meron tayong mga ganong project para mabawasan yung risk na magka-dengue uli anak o kaya magbigay ng mga insect repellents. Kasi yan lang, that's the least that you can do for us. Maliit na budget lang po yan. Lahat na sana na kaya nyong itulong sa amin, gawin nyo na. Kasi gobyerno ang nagkasala sa amin eh. Gobyerno ang nagpahamak, nagpalagay sa mga anak namin sa kapahamakan. Sa pagdesisyon nyo in haste, hindi nyo man lang pinag-isipang mabuti. Siguro nung nagdesisyon kayo, ang konsensya nyo ay tinago nyo muna sa inyong mga bulsa or sa bag o kung saan. Dapat ang pagdesisyon natin ay kasabay parati ang konsensya to have a good, sound judgment over things. Your Honor.
Okay po. Huwag muna po tayo mag-accuse na po. Dahil kaya nga tayo parehas dito para malaman natin ang importante. Alam ko ang silakbo ng damdamin ng marami at yan ay ina-handle po ng gobyerno. Pero naiintindihan ko yung silakbo niya. Pero wala muna tayo ganyan. Lalabas at lalabas.
Okay po.
Sa legal na pamaraan. Okay. Po. The meantime, let everybody know, Senator Hontiveros is here, present. I would just like to recognize also our expert here, Dr. She was raising her hand. Mary Ann Lansa. Go ahead, please. Pakibilis na ko because we have a 3 o'clock session.
Thank you po.
Pagka matagal kayo, papasaksak ko kayo ng dengue uli. Thank you. Sipa.
Your Honor, this is just a point of information when Secretary Duque said were there cases of DHF, dengue hemorrhagic fever 3. The New England Journal of Medicine publication of Hadinegoro et al., which is always cited by Sanofi, says that there were 2 cases of grade 3 DHF among the vaccinees.
Tagalog, please. Hindi namin maintindihan. Hindi po kami mga doktor. Ganda yung sinasabi yung type 1, type 2, type 3. Hindi ko po type yan. Kailangan maintindihan po natin.
Yung type 1 and type 2, kahit na ho tawag na dengue hemorrhagic fever, wala hong shock. So hindi, in layman's terms, hindi sobrang severe. Pero ang dengue hemorrhagic fever 3, grade 3, ay may shock po. So yan yung mga medyo delikado. And it's recorded in the New England Journal of Medicine publication that there were 2 cases in the vaccine group that had that DHF grade 3. No, in the meta-analysis, the global pooled analysis for the Sanofi vaccine. The other point I wanted to say is when we talk about decreasing the risk of severe dengue, it is always quoted as a percentage. That is quite misleading when you say dengue is reduced by 90%, or in terms of severe dengue, or hospitalization by 80%. We need to know the baseline risk, and that's not always communicated well. The baseline risk is very low, so that when you talk about the cost of using that vaccine to prevent severe dengue, then you're talking about figures of 100,000. So we need to really make good decisions when we adopt a particular vaccine for public health purposes. The baseline risk is very important to communicate.
Nasabi po ba niyo, hindi muna dapat dinahos-dahos ito?
Well, from my point of view.
Ano po yung point of view niyo? Sabihin niyo na po dito.
From my point of view, it was premature to launch a mass immunization program.
Hindi po ba, it was premature to have a mass immunization program. Tatlong region po yung ginawa.
Mass yeah. Immunization program po yun kasi
mass immunization
talking about
na rin po
thousands.
Million.
The reason why, well, I did say in the past hearing that Dengvaxia is a breakthrough vaccine, and it still holds because it can protect seropositive persons from severe dengue in the future. But we need to look at the downside, which is the safety. And that was not really considered. Consider that the primary endpoint of the studies was just protection against symptomatic dengue. It was not The secondary endpoint was severe dengue and hospitalization, which the clinical trials were not powered enough. In other words, the sample size was not enough to show significant differences in the vaccine group and the placebo group.
All right, can I say, ma'am, therefore, that this was premature according to you and that we shouldn't have done it? We should have waited because, after all, ang hindi nyo sinasabi dito ay sa Pilipinas lang ito inumpisahan at saka sa Brazil at saka sa Mexico. Walang tumanggap sa Singapore for public use. Walang tumanggap sa Malaysia at kaya ang pinapasok ang Indonesia. Eh, siyempre, yung sinasabi nyo, may mga averages na pagka nagka-dengue kayo, tatamaan pa rin kayo, bababa ang hospitalization. Tama po yun, pero hindi kayo satisfied doon. Dapat ang sinasabi nyo ay malinaw dapat na makakatulong ito sa tao pag in-administer ito. Yun po ba sinasabi nyo?
Kasi ang sinasabi ko po, the absence of evidence is not proof that it is absent.
All right. Okay, so sa mga tweet, many of us and many of the people here are quite chagrined because some of
then henceforward, sir, Secretary Garbin, with this dengue vaccine. So many questions, sir. Number one, who allowed it? Who signs off? Is there a bids and awards committee? Are you a member of the bids and awards? Can you help us understand what goes on in the Department of Health or how this happened?
Okay, the Department of Health has several bids and awards committee. One of the bids and awards committee is a awards committee that actually procures vaccines. We procure about 9 vaccines annually, and the annual budget for that's about 2.7 billion annually to immunize 2 million kids for the whole country. Now here you are telling government saying we need 3.5 billion and I'm going to vaccinate only 3 regions and target school age kids. So that's more than the program we actually spent for our whole immunization program for measles, TB, hepatitis, all those other diseases. So on the cost-benefit side, it's really a problem already. Now you ask me, how is this done? It's not in the budget of 2015. It's not in the budget of 2016. If we had an earth-shaking vaccine that came out that will save lives, I'm going to go to Senate and ask for a supplemental budget. I go, it's not budgeted, but a new discovery came out, and I think the Filipinos will benefit. The process, the correct process, is ask for a supplemental budget, and the one that gives that budget is Congress and Senate. So that's usually done. That's usually asked for, but this one didn't go through that. So again, in that process, when you say this was thought up and panahon pa ni Ona, that's not true. That's a lie. Garin is caught lying because she met in May with Sanofi officials in Paris.
In 2015?
The pictures are there. The ambassador's report is there. Mm-hmm. And after that, she started to request for funding.
Now I'm just going to say this, Dr. Herbosa. She says that there was no malice. She forgot. She said it was 2 years ago. Nakalimutan daw niya. Do you believe that?
I don't. I think that's another lie. I think that's another lie that there's no malice because right after the May, in December 22, the drug was registered by FDA, and she was the acting FDA director.
I wanted to go to that too, but here the question is, she says that there was no malice. In fact, if there was malice, why would I be with members of the Department of Foreign Affairs?
Let me tell you,
a good point,
when
sir?
I became undersecretary, the first thing the people in the Department of Health told me was, sir, you cannot meet with suppliers and contractors of government. Because that's another procurement process. There's impropriety. There's impropriety in that. Because if you see me whining and dining with a supplier that makes hospital equipment, or that's not appropriate. And then you hear they have a deal with the Department of Health. I've been told that. So I suppose she's been told that. And I think that's civil service rules. That's why you have a procurement, a back that does the tender.
The Bids and Awards
Committee. The Bids and Awards Committee is a party that will make the decision and not the head of the agency.
So who made the decision? Was it the BAC or was it Secretary Garin?
I think it was Secretary Garin.
You think you're not sure?
No, I'm sure because she announced this in her TV interviews. You can go back to all the media interviews in January, and she announced it and she said she's allotting money for it. What now amazes me is she again lied about where the money came from. The money came from savings.
Okay, so
again, that's another something that's totally I think I can call it illegal, because for government funds to be spent, 3.5 billion pesos, you need to go to Congress and Senate.
Where was the money taken from? Where was it sourced from?
Here, the funny thing, she says it was, initially she says it was from Sintax. And then she changes again. The same way with this dinner and wining and dining. She says now it's coming from the unused retirement funds of government employees. So again to me, when I hear that, oops, my ears will get hot, because you cannot use personal expenses to buy products and supplies. That's technical malversation.
Who will give us the truth behind where the funds were sourced from, Dr. Herbos?
The Department of Budget
and Management. It's still the DBM.
Because the Department of Budget Management has a paper trail in this one.
Right.
Because they issue what is called a sub-allotment release order. And anytime, if we want to buy something, the first thing we need to get is that sub-allotment release order.
Do you know where the money was sourced from, sir?
Personally, no. But from news, it says it's from savings of something. But it was not appropriated by Congress and Senate.
Not in 2015 and not even in 2016. 2016.